你们听得见我的声音吗？非常好，同学们好，又见面了。所以呢，这次又是我一个人。
So it was in the summer of 2018 when Dylan and I were on a service trip to a province called Ningxia in China. And it was a very poor province. We were in this rural village where they had inadequate English teachers. So we also realized, however, that if we only taught English during the duration of a trip, we wouldn't have created any lasting impact. And so we actually started teaching using Zoom back all the way back in 2018.
Yeah, so I joined EFA as a teacher in 2018, I believe. And I was really a freshman who didn't know anything. Joining EFA thinking, you know, it would give me kind of, you know, an experience of high school.
So I joined EFA back in 2019. The way I found out about EFA was through WeChat. Actually, my mom saw like a WeChat message sent by Dylan.
Something that we all slowly realized, our first group of volunteers, was that we didn't really know what we were doing at the beginning.
At that time, we didn't have really established teams. We taught using Word documents, and it was really just a sign up and teach.
But then we slowly started improving what we were doing. We went from preparing 20 minutes before class on a Google document to creating a full-fledged curriculum, and going from having very temporary teachers who only taught around 2 or 3 classes to having permanent teachers who taught for the entire year round, 30 to 40 classes every year.
Everything changed.
We were like splitting into divisions and
kind of set a clear basis, you know, between teaching curriculum team, marketing, financial, Edge.
We started last year a new program called Edge Mentorship that provides a big brother, big sister relationship to left behind children in order to help them deal with their mental health needs.
One of my mentors, her student actually opened up to her about a problem with her friend. It was a very personal problem, and the fact that she opened up and the fact that she actually felt like comforted by her mentor is one of like her favorite memories.
I distinctly remember a kid, his name was Kevin. He was learning everything very fast. But after class, I went to this little corner to use the restroom, right? And I saw him with probably his younger siblings. And he was teaching them the exact same thing we just taught them about 15 minutes ago. And I just stood there and I was like, wow, wait, what?
When we did our first fundraiser in the March of 2020, we expected to raise around $200 and $300, and we ended up raising over $5,000. It was while we made these improvements that we really started falling in love with EFA, and we were slowly realizing that this wasn't something that, you know, we started as something to pad our resume. This was something that we started that is actually creating a genuine impact.
We, as EFA, is literally changing lives.
And we have really exciting things planned. We are developing AI algorithms. We're planning on maybe even teaching Chinese to countries like India and Kazakhstan, setting up a microfinance program. And so even with all of these developments, I think that at the end of the day,
just knowing that I had been able to be part of an organization that was a movement that could like provide these resources.
People from all aspects of life coming together to help underprivileged children that they never met.
When we realized that, it was the most satisfying feeling we've ever felt, because it was more meaningful than anything else we'd done in our lives.
Yeah.